As I told you, these two types of connections, okay, copper straight through and copper crossover. So copper straight through connections are used with the devices which operate at different layers, okay, of computer models or network models, okay. For example, a copper straight through connection can be used to connect a computer system or the PC with a switch or hub, okay. And the second connection, that is the copper crossover, okay, it can be used to connect the devices which operate on the same layer, okay. Suppose you want to connect two routers or the two switches or the two hubs together, okay. So in that case, we will use copper crossover connection, right? So this other connection also we'll talk about later, okay. Currently we are using these two connections, okay, and the details, okay, regarding this, means more details if you want to get, okay, simply click on help section, okay, go to content, okay, and in the content you will see the search option, okay, click on search, and here you can write the keywords, okay, cables, devices, or anything you can search, okay. So currently we are working on logical workspace. So you go to logical workspace and here you can get the details, okay, with the diagram, right? So now if
sir, how did what did you do just now, sir?
No, see here, help section is there, okay.
Okay,
click on help section, go to contents, okay, and then here in the search option, first option is search, okay, means here table of content is also there, but this is very big, okay, so it will take more time get your topic of interest, okay. Simply you click on search, and then here you can type any keyword you can type, okay, like cables. Suppose I want to search about cable, what type of cables are there, what type of devices are there, okay. So you can click on submit, okay, then you can see the different topics which talks about this keyword, okay. So here two types of workspaces are there, okay, physical and the logical. So currently we are working on the logical workspace, okay. So we will go to this logical workspace, okay, and here you can see the components, devices, okay, which is used, okay. Here also it is shown along with the figure, okay. So this you can also explore, okay. So this will give you more idea about the available devices or the available equipments over here, okay. So I talked about network devices, their types, okay, what types of different devices, subtypes are also available, okay, then end devices, and then connections, right? So now, okay, coming to suppose here basically we will try to create a small network, okay, wherein we will connect two systems together, okay, and then we will see whether they are connected or not, okay. Then how we will see? By sending the data from one PC to another PC, right? So all of you also do it along with me, so there should not be any confusion. So first of all, what we require? We require two systems, okay. So what we need to do? We need to click on end devices. All of you please click on end devices, okay, and then click on means you can choose one PC, okay, click on PC and then click on this blank space, okay, and otherwise you can drag it also, right? In the same way you connect, you take one more PC and put it onto this screen, okay. So now two PCs we have taken. Now we need to connect these two PCs, okay. So we can use connections, then click on connections, okay, and in this basically, as I told you, so which type of connections we need to use? Copper straight through or copper crossover connection? So here you can use copper crossover, okay, connection, right? Click on this crossover, and then you click on the first PC. Once you will click, it will show the number of ports available, okay, to this device. So one RS232 port is there, okay, two USB ports are there, and one fast Ethernet port is available to this device, okay. So of course we will use the fast Ethernet port to connect these two devices, okay. Then what you need to do after that, click on connections, okay. We have taken two PCs, right? Now we need to connect these two using a appropriate connection type, okay. So click on this connection. Yes, all of okay. You can see connection, yes or no?
Yes sir.
Yes,
click
sir.
On connection, okay, and then click on this PC. Sorry, connection is not in this connection. Then here the connection types will be available, right? So from here you can select copper crossover. Once you will hover your mouse, it will show at the bottom, okay, what type of cable it is. So this cable you can select, right? Once I have selected, so you can see the selection option is also over here, okay. Means this option is selected, and then finally this cable means this connection type you have selected, and then click on the first PC, okay. Then you will see the options, means the ports available to this device. RS232 port is there, okay, that is basically used to connect monitor, right? Two USB ports are there, okay, and one fast Ethernet port is there, right?
Yes sir.
So you got four ports, but here which one to utilize? We are using crossover connection, okay. So so we will use fast Ethernet port, okay. So click on this. It means you have means one side of that cable you have connected to fast Ethernet port of PC2, okay. Then extend this, click on second PC, right? Same thing here also you need to do. You select fast Ethernet port here also, okay. So you can see these two PCs are connected through this wire connection, okay, and you can see the triangle option is also there, okay, that is in green color. It means the link is up, okay. So now these two devices are ready to transmit the data, means there is no error in connection, right? Sometimes you will see red color also, correct, triangles, okay. So in case of this Windows system, you will see triangle, okay. If you are using the Linux one, then sometimes you, there may be a bit difference, okay, maybe circle or the circle you will see, okay. There is a bit difference in the user interface, okay. Okay, you can place it to appropriate place, okay. And then what we need to do up to this point, all of you have completed, please confirm.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes sir.
Okay, so all of you have done this, okay.
Roger, roger.
And then what is the next thing what we need to do? So here you can see two options, okay. These are the message types, okay. One is the simple PDU, other is the complex PDU. PDU stands for packet data unit, okay. So this message we will take and we'll try to send it from PC2 to PC3, right? But can we send it right now? Simply, okay, suppose you try, okay, take one PDU, click on the source PC, and then click on the destination PC. So you are getting the error. What error you are getting? PC3 has no functional ports. Okay, so why this error is coming? Because this PC we have simply connected through a wire connection, right? But we have not even configured these two PCs with the IP addresses, right? Means we are not even telling which is the source device and which is the destination device, okay, where this message needs to be transmitted, right? Because they will communicate based on the IP address, Okay. So first of all, what we need to do, we need to configure these two PCs. Okay. So click on first PC. Okay. Then you will get this window. Here you go to desktop. Okay. And in the desktop, you will see several options. Then go to IP configuration. Click on IP configuration. So I am going slowly only. Okay. So please let me know in case if you are not able to. Okay. So what you need to do, you click on the first PC. Double click also you can do. Okay. Then this window will get popped up. After that, what you need to do, you need to click on desktop. Okay, several options are visible over here, like physical, config, desktop, okay, programming, attribute. Click on desktop. Then here you click on IP configuration, first option. Okay. So here you will see this static option. Okay. Currently, we need to use the static, we need to assign a static IP address, okay, to this device. Okay, this another option is DSCP, that is for dynamic assignment of IP addresses, okay, from pool of IP addresses. So that we will see later. Currently you see IP address, and here you can choose one of the IP address. Okay, suppose I am taking 192.168.0. Suppose I am taking 5, okay, IP version 4, okay. So here I told you two types of notations are there. First one is the dotted decimal. Second one is the binary notation. Okay, so if we consider this dotted decimal notation, okay. So here I also just told you this IPv4 address is of 32 bit length, right? So now how many addresses we can generate? Total 2^32, maximum 2^32 IP addresses we can generate using IP version 4. Okay, so here this 32 bit IP address, okay, this entire range of addresses, okay, has been divided into separate different classes. Okay, class A, class B, okay, C, D, and E, likewise. Okay, and how it is being represented as 32 bit address. Okay, so if I write it like this, okay, so this is of 32 bit length. Okay, it is basically divided into two parts. Okay, one part is known as network ID, other part is known as host ID. Okay, and this basically how many number of bits will be used for the network ID and remaining bits will be used for the host ID. Okay, is decided by which class address it is, right? So all the class A addresses, okay, so here if I write class A, okay, class A address type, so here basically first 8 bits, okay, first 8 bits are used as network ID, right? I will not go in detail, okay, only few things currently I'll tell you so that it will be clear to all of you. Okay, so first 8 bit are used as network ID, and remaining how many bits, here I'm writing like this, okay, remaining here it will be how many bits, 24 bits are used as host ID. Okay, this is for class A address I am telling. Okay, but if you see the first bit, okay, first bit of all the class addresses are reserved. Okay, so it always starts with zero, right? So here I can write the range also, range of address. Okay, so here if we will say the class address range is 1.0.0.02. Okay, here I am writing in dotted decimal notation. Okay, two. It will go up to 126.255.255.255. Okay. Are you getting the point? The class B means entire range. Okay, entire range of this IP address. Okay, 2^32 addresses. Okay, that has been divided into different blocks. Okay. From here to here, we are calling class A. From here to here, we are calling class B. From here to here, we are calling class C. Likewise, okay? So class C, class B basically starts from 128, okay? .0.0.0 to it goes up to 191.255.255.255. Okay, similarly class C starts from 192.0.0.0, okay, and it goes up to 223.255.255.255. okay, so these ranges we'll write later also. So here just now you see which address we have utilized to assign to that device. It is falling in which class? That is falling in class C address. Okay, so class C range is starting from 192.0.0.0 to 223.255.255.255. Okay, got it. And class C, if we say here 8 bits and 24 bits has been used for the class A. Okay, similarly for class B, 16 and 16. Okay, 16 bits are used as for the network ID, and 16 bit for the host ID. Okay, similarly for class C, first 24 bits are used as network ID and remaining 8 bits are used as host ID. Okay, so you can see is how this has been generated. Okay, if we say how many networks we can generate, so using 8 bit only 2^8 networks we can generate. Okay, and how many hosts we can generate? 2^24, right? Because in all 2^8 networks, okay, these many hosts can be connected. Are you getting my point? Okay, so now coming to that point, coming back to our Cisco packet tracer. Okay, so here we can see, so that's what, here I am selecting only class C address. Okay, so you can choose other numbers also. Okay, here.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this I have taken one of the address, class C address. Okay, so you can see for class C how many network bits are there. For class C, 24 bits are used as network bit and remaining 8 bits are used as host bit. So that is why you see, corresponding to all 24 bits, okay, it is 1, all 1, okay. So if you write all 1, then it will come 255.255.255, okay. If it is a class B address, then what will be its subnet mask? Because in class B, first 16 bits are used as network ID, okay. So all 16 bits will be 111, okay, and remaining will be 0. So it will be 255.255.0.0, okay. For class A, it will be 255.0.0.0, okay. Okay, so all of you have done up to this point. Close this. Same thing you have to do for the second system also. Click on that, go to desktop, go to ipconfig, and IP address now. Then other IP address you need to put, okay. So for example, I have chosen 192.168.0.0.0. 0.5 I have chosen, here I can write 6. Okay, 0.6 I am writing. And then click on this, it will take subnet mask automatically. Close this, right? Okay, so we have done the IP configuration for these two systems. Okay, so all of you have done up to this point. Now what you need to do, click on this simple PDU, okay, or select this simple PDU, okay, and then click on the source PC and then destination PC, right? We will see the simulation also over here. So in the simulation, you can see the scenario also here. Basically, when you will drop a PDU, okay. So here various scenarios will get created. So as you can see here, scenario zero is there, okay, and you can see the detail also. So last status is showing in progress, okay. And what is the source? That is PC2. What is the destination? That is PC3. Okay. Type, you can see it is written one ICMP. So this is one of the protocol. Okay. Because at each layer, the protocols are also used. Okay. The protocols are nothing but these are the set of rules. Okay. So using this protocol only, data communication can happen, okay, between these two PCs. Okay, so different layer you will find different types of protocols. Okay, so that details we will see later.
Mike is saying it has failed.
It has failed in last progress. It is showing failed in your case, right?
Yes sir.
It means this is not means your cable is properly connected.
Yes sir.
Okay, so have you seen the IP configuration also? Please yes. Check that also. Okay, that is fine, no issue. Then after that you come to simulation. Okay, we will see the simulation part. Okay, click on simulation, this window will get enabled. Okay, and then finally click on edit filters. Okay, here basically what you do, in you can see IPv4 protocols, IPv6 protocol, okay, and then some of the miscellaneous protocols. So what you need to do in IPv4, uncheck all except ICMP. In your case, by default, all the protocols will be in checked, right?
Okay sir.
So uncheck, click on ICMP, and then what you need to do, you close this, okay. And then now we will see the simulation, means how this message or the data packet will be transmitted from PC2 to PC3. Okay. And then finally, it will send the acknowledgement also. Okay. And which will be received by the PC2. So when we will say that our data has been successfully transmitted, when the source PC will receive the acknowledgement of the same. Okay. Right. So now what you need to do, click on this button, the display button over here. Okay. Once you will click, then it will, your message will start. You can see the simulation. Okay. It has reached to PC3 and then PC3 has sent the acknowledgement also. Okay. And it has been received by the PC2 and you can see the tick mark also over here. It means the message has been successfully transmitted from PC2 to PC3. And you can see the scenario also, it has been changed now. Now last status is successful. Okay. Earlier it was in progress. Now it is showing successful. So from here also you can verify whether the data packet has been successfully transmitted or not.
Yes, sir. Done, sir.